Okay, so what I'll be doing is just removing the cables running from the battery to the starter motor and the ground, and I'm going to try and test them a bit more today. Yeah, so that's the lead there, and it looks very healthy to me. I can't see anything that could possibly be wrong with that. It all looks fairly new. It may even have been renewed. That is to say, it may not be the one that came with the bike when it was first made. Yeah, whenever doing any of these types of tests, it's very important to just pause for a second and make sure that you've got the positive on the positive side and the negative on the negative side. It's actually easier than you think to get them the wrong way around. Yeah, so I've actually done this test before. I've got the battery connected up to the starter motor, and I'll show you the result. So obviously there's absolutely nothing wrong with these, because it's showing the same result without them installed. One thing that I'm not sure of is the question, is the starter motor grounded to the ground of the, is it connected to the engine, to the metal, is there a good ground? And to find that out, I'm going to have to undo these two bolts that keep the starter motor on, and there's a gasket just here. And what I'll do is remove the gasket and make sure that the starter motor body is bolted onto the metal of the frame. So yeah, there's nothing wrong with the ground. I've got a lead going from the starter motor body to the actual housing, primary chain housing, and you'll see that it's made no difference. Okay, so with the spark plugs removed, I'm going to demonstrate that the engine's not seized. I'll demonstrate that the engine will turn. Well, I've got to say that this is a very strange problem I'm having with this bike. With the spark plugs removed, I can crank the engine. I can get the engine to rotate. So it's almost as if it's not getting enough power. So the battery is connected, and I'll switch it on. The spark plugs are out, and I'll push the starter button. I'd just like to point out that I've tried three batteries on this bike. One of the batteries is from a car. It's a big marine battery, and it had the same effect. It didn't improve it. But now that I've got the spark plugs out, I can demonstrate that the starter motor will turn the engine, but it doesn't seem to have enough power. So I'll just demonstrate that again with the spark plugs removed. Okay, so at last I've made a good breakthrough with the problem with the starter motor. Now I'll just explain what I've found. Okay, so the starter relay plugs into this junction here. That's the joiner there. And what I can do, I found that if I get a piece of cable like this, and I bridge, you know, bypass this this relay switch, and if I run a cable from there to there, I can get the starter motor to work. So before I go any further, I'd like to say that I'm not a mechanic. I can keep a car running. You know, it's going to take me sort of 10 times longer to diagnose a problem than a mechanic. I don't recommend that you try this test. If you do, you want to be very safe and understand what you're doing. I'll just say once more, I'm not a mechanic. And so I'll just show what I've found. Okay, so I'm going to turn the ignition on. and I'll bypass that relay switch. And you can see that that's got a fair amount of power. So what I'll be doing now is I'll reinstall the spark plugs and I'll see if it still cranks over. Whenever you're doing up any type of spark plug or any thread, don't tighten it up too much. It's very easy to strip a thread. Just be responsible. Just like to point out one more time that what I'm showing here is my way of diagnosing a fault. It may not be the correct one, so you want to do your own research. And here we go. The spark plug's in. I turn on the ignition, and hopefully, Okay. So measuring across the fuse with the fuse removed. On the first one there, I've got 30.2 volts. So that's removed, and I'll connect the multimeter now. 30.2. And on the second one, there is 28 volts. And then we have the next fuse removed. It's about 11.4 volts. And so the last fuse removed, and let's see what the reading is. 1056. That's a 12 volt system, and I've got 1056, and this one was reading around about 11 from memory.